The question that's often asked is this is the world, if you like, is this real or unreal? And the most accurate answer is, well, yes and no, frustratingly. In other words, this is both real and unreal. In a sense, this, by which I mean whatever is arising, whatever experiences are arising, we could say is the only reality. If the word real, if the word reality, if they mean anything, and I want to suggest to you that they clearly do mean something, if the words real and reality mean anything, this is what they mean. We could say this is what they point to, because words can only ever point, we might say. So this experience, whatever is happening, the sound of a voice, the sight of something appearing, the feeling of the pressure of a body upon a seat, a feeling of heat on this, which is one of the hottest days of the year so far. These are all what we could call experiences, and this is what is real. The sound of a voice is real. A thought is real. It's a real thought. But we can also say that in a very important sense, it is unreal. Or perhaps it might be clearer to say that it's an illusion. Now, the word illusion is important and is often misunderstood, because when we use the word illusion, a lot of times it's taken to mean that something simply doesn't exist, if you like, that it's imaginary rather than real. But that's not what the word illusion really means. The word illusion means that what is appearing is different to what we might take it to be. If it's an illusion, it is different to the reality, in inverted commas, that we take it to be. And so what we could say about this is that this is a real illusion. For example, it seems to be full, but in actuality, it's empty. So it's not what it seems to be. It seems to be, well, it may be full of all sorts of things, of all sorts of experiences, all sorts of feelings may arise. And yet, in actuality, this is an outpouring, we could say, of unconditional love. And yet, to the one who's sitting in a chair or sitting on a bus or walking down the streets experiencing it, that may very much not seem to be what it is. So it's an illusion in the sense that it is something different to how it appears. So the world, reality, experience, whatever we want to call it, is both real and unreal. The problem for the person, the one who feels himself to be separate and solid and living within something which seems to be an external world, the problem for the person is that this only appears to be real. Its unreality is not also seen. Now, the person may become interested in philosophical or spiritual matters and may intellectualize in all sorts of ways that this isn't actually real. But that has no value because it's just another thought or another way of thinking. What's transformative is when this is seen to be unreal. And yet its reality also continues. Now, a related question which occurs is awakening ordinary or is it extraordinary? And again, as with the answer to the first question that I posed in this short video, perhaps frustratingly, perhaps even annoyingly, the answer to that question is both yes and no. In a sense, we could say that awakening is the most ordinary thing in the world, because we could say that in awakening, nothing changes. In awakening, it's simply seen that the experiencer, the apparent experiencer of all the experiences, simply does not exist, is simply empty. And so we could say that everything in awakening simply goes on as before. No flashing lights, no exalted spiritual angels fluttering about. Everything remains perfectly everyday and perfectly normal. It's just recognized that it's not arising for anyone, or it's not being experienced by anyone. Experiences there are, but no experiencer. So in a sense, we could say, well, it's completely ordinary. It's totally everyday. If there's a person who is drinking a cup of tea, and then this is seen, there's simply the drinking of a cup of tea. It's just that there's no one doing that. And yet, in another sense, we could say that awakening is most definitely not ordinary, or that it is extraordinary, because it's extraordinary to see that the one who had apparently experienced something called their life for however many apparent years they have been on this planet, whatever the age, 20, 30, 40, 50, it doesn't matter. It's absolutely extraordinary for the one who felt that they were a separate person experiencing all of this, that that person does not actually exist. There is, if you like, only emptiness where the person seems to be. So that all of this, everything, every part of reality is simply arising, but it's not arising for anyone. It's simply appearing, but it's not appearing to anyone or for anyone. And instead of a person experiencing all of this, it may be apprehended that instead of a person experiencing all of this, there is simply the arising of unconditional love. And that cannot really, in any sense of the phrase, be described as ordinary. So yes, awakening is ordinary in the sense that everything just goes on as before, and it's extraordinary in the sense that it's seen that the everything that's happening is not happening for anyone, and that unconditional love is the case, and that unconditional love has nothing to do with me or who I thought that I am. And that's a topic that may be worth returning to later on in another talk during this series. But I'll end there with a little summary. Is this real or unreal? It's both. Is awakening ordinary or extraordinary? It's both. And I'll leave you with that.